A common misconception is that an N95 mask is basically a really fine strainer, a mesh of fibers with gaps too small for particles to get through. It's not like a sieve. What passes through the mask doesn't really depend on the size of gaps as in the case of a strainer. An N95 mask is actually really good at filtering the largest and the smallest of particles. Almost always it's the medium-sized small particles that it is afraid of and is hardest for it to block. The objective of an N95 mask is to get an airborne particle to touch a fiber in the mask. Once it touches a fiber, it sticks to it and doesn't go flying back again. What fraction of those sneaky medium-sized particles gets blocked gives you the number of the mask. If at least 95% of those particles are filtered out, then the mask is rated N95. Three magical mechanisms are involved in this. At a microscopic level, everything is sticking because the weakly attractive force between molecules is strong enough to hold small things in place. The objective is to get particles to touch their fiber. More layers of sticky fiber means more chances of particles to get stuck. And how likely particles are to hit or miss a fiber depend on their size. Particles of 1 micron or larger in size basically travel in straight lines because of their inertia. And because there are many layers of fibers, they are bound to hit a fiber and stick. Particles that are really small, usually of 0.1 microns, are so light that collision with air molecules literally bounce them around. So they move in a random zigzag pattern known as Brownian motion. This zigzagging makes it super likely that a particle will bump into a fiber and get stuck. Particles of in-between sizes are the worst. That's because they don't travel in straight lines and they also don't bounce around randomly. Instead, they are carried along with the air as it flows around the fibers, meaning they are likely to get carried past fibers and sneak through even a mask with many layers. But there is another defensive mechanism. Fibers of N95 mask can attract particles of all sizes to them using an electric field. In presence of electric field, even neutral particles develop an internal electric imbalance that attracts them to the source of the field. And no, you don't need to hook up a battery to your mask to get an electric field. Their fibers are specially electrocharged, meaning they give out permanent electric fields all the time. By using these electrocharged fibers in an N95 mask, they gain a long-lasting ability to attract particles, which means they capture a heck lot of particles. Any cloth or commercially available face mask can achieve the first and second principle with little effort. The third stage of electrostatic attraction is one of the several design features that sets the N95 mask apart from other face masks. Coronavirus is 0.1 micrometer in diameter, and wearing a mask really helps blocking out this insanity. Plus, you get to hide your face, so wear a damn mask and tell others to wear one. And also, share this video to educate others.